Hello, yes, Pauline Hanson, Baker stunt in the Senate, Queensland, was it? Australia. You see, I'll tell you why dramatic stunts like that backfire, and they're not good for us. If you remember, and I'm not having a go, I'm just highlighting a point here, I wouldn't have noticed it at first, I'm sure you didn't, Nick Griffin, but once I looked at it, from outside the goldfish bowl, I could see that it was bad. When you were holding the placard, "Hate preachers out," it was a mirror association. It reflected back to you. In fact, there was a journalist that tried to find the clip, but I can't. There's a journalist that points that out. He said, "Hate preachers," and then points at you, and you give a silly smirk. Very funny, or whatever it is you said. Now, it's not your fault. I'm not having a go, right? I'm just highlighting how these stunts, or it wasn't really a stunt in your case, it was just a bad move. Either someone had wrote them out wrong, or someone's done it deliberate. Someone's a bit more shrewd and understands these things. But anyway, that backfired on you, Nick, didn't it, when you're holding the placard? "Hate preachers out." You're holding it. "Hate preachers." Well, who were the hate preachers? Well, it's you. It was a mid association. Well, it's the same with Pauline Hanson. Forget the Pauline Hanson supporters, One Nation party members, or Pauline Hanson sycophants. Forget them. We all think along the same lines. But the average person looking at the picture of Pauline Hanson in a Baker sitting there in the Senate would have immediately came to the conclusion, wow, who's that weirdo? That photo is scary. Now, the average person, not your sycophant supporters, they don't work things out like me and you do. Yeah, it's Pauline Hanson behind it making a point. They don't work it out like that like we do, right? We already know they're not. As I've said, the public are not thinkers, let alone nationalists. They're just voters. So, whatever newspapers that picture was in, or whatever newsreels it was on, it would have been scary for the average person looking at it. They'd have just seen Pauline Hanson dressed as a Muslim in a burqa. It would be confusing and also scary for them. These stunts backfire. Plus, let's be honest and realistic here. What Muslim woman wearing a burqa, full face, is about to be elected to the Senate in Queensland? Well, none, exactly. It was silly. It was a silly move. And also, again, we don't want to ban the burqa. We want it in everyone's face. We don't want to ban mosques. We want more. We don't want to help the system assimilate them. We want to bring the bleeding system down. We don't want to help them pull the wool further over people's eyes. We want more burqas and mosques, right? So it's a bad move on that alone. But also, I believe it's a bad move because she looks scary sitting there, doesn't she? Now, I know who it is. You know who it is. The public, I know they all know who it is. But they don't think like that. They'll just, whoa, who's that? She's a nutter, that Pauline Hanson. Look at her. What does she look like? That's scary. Now, they won't understand what point she's making, even though they do. They're not that stupid. But it will have a different effect on them. And also, it looks like you're bullying them. And that's the last thing we want to do, give them victimhood status. They've had enough of that after Grenfell Tower, you know, and whatever. And many other incidents that have happened. Now, they backfire them stunts, right? Anything dramatic, one Nick Griffin was proposing a while ago, going to judges' homes and, I don't know, having a picket outside or whatever. That's give a paedophile a lenient sentence. Well, number one, the public would never thank you for that because they don't care because it doesn't affect their children, right? And again, the judge would come out the one that's the victim getting bullied, right? Because you've got this mob outside his home shouting, judge, or whatever, Griffin, right? Or someone climbing on the roof, or even worse. So all them dramatic stunts, they don't work now in 2017. Maybe years ago, and it's a maybe, right? A highly unlikely. So Pauline Hanson Baker stunt, that will backfire that. Trust me, right? I've got on this now, right? And I never studied any psychology at school or university or anywhere, right? But I can see it. It's so obvious now what it's happening where we're making big mistakes. Some of it will just be genuine mistakes by us, and we have to put our hands up and, you know, correct it and make sure we don't do it again, instead of trying to justify, oh no, what did I show you? But anyway, so yeah, Pauline Hanson's Baker stunt is a bad move, if you ask me. And like I've said, we want more Bakers in people's faces. We don't want it banned. We don't want to assimilate them. So the Baker's banned, Miss Hanson. But all right, assimilating them then, are we? Well, that's just nonsense, isn't it? We don't want to do that. We want them out, right? We want more mosques, we want more Bakers. We want it in people's faces, right? So they understand that their culture, their way of life's being displaced, right? We don't want to assimilate them where we can't see them and they fit in happily ever after. You're just going along with the multicultural agenda then, aren't you? That's another reason. Bet no one thought of that one, did they? But anyway, yeah, so Pauline Hanson, have a look at that picture long and hard. I'll leave a screenshot of it for several seconds and look at it. It's sitting there in the corner like some little weirdo. Okay, thank you.